demand, and it's not going away. The demand is still there. It's not slowing down. As you can see behind me, this line, John, it started forming even earlier this morning, and it's even longer at this hour. People waiting in the cold to get care. The hospital tells us every day they are working to increase the capacity of this hospital by flooding it with nurses and doctors and equipment just to keep up with this demand.
I don't see, I've been here for an hour. Not one person has walked up to the tents. Not one. Okay? So, and look at all the ambulances down the block. You see any ambulances?
Somebody else take a video.
Look at, more people are taking videos because no one's believing the fake media. You see all the ambulances that are on the block down there?
Everybody's
They're all parked. They've been there for an hour.
Elmhurst Hospital in Queens is now the epicenter of the five boroughs. So many people lined up to get testing, confirmed cases there. Doctors and nurses are inundated.
Elmhurst Hospital, as you said, has really become the hot zone. Every single day, patients are lining up outside here, many of them with cold and flu-like symptoms. They come here to be tested.
I'm standing outside of the Elmhurst Hospital Center in Queens, New York, and according to the media, this is the epicenter of the apocalypse, but it sure looks like a ghost town to me. Look on the YouTube, the CBS News, long lines of people trying to get tested. I don't see that. Now here's those tents they had set up. This is what you saw on the news.
With the growing number of patients as supplies dwindle. You can see barricades behind us set up here outside of the hospital to keep order here because so many have been lining up every day to get tested.
13 people have died at this hospital in Queens, while outside it's swamped with New Yorkers waiting in long lines to get tested for the coronavirus. The numbers in the city are still rapidly growing, but the nation's top infectious disease expert says studying what's happening here could give clues to help reduce infection rates in other parts of the country.
It's accelerating. There are other parts of the country which we need to get a better feel for what is going on. And the way we do that is by increasing testing and identifying people who are infected, isolating them, getting out of circulation, and then do contact tracing. It doesn't matter what you say 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, you've got to go with what the situation on the ground is.
I don't see anything wrong.